Hello everybody, welcome back to Red Toolhouse. Today we are going to get the roof on the chicken church and get it dried in a little bit there. But first we've got to paint some of our trim because we're going to put the roof on with the drip edge, with the edge trim, all that type of stuff. Something that's going to look really nice. So Kelly and I are going to put our paint on. What we did earlier when we worked on this last time, we didn't cover it last, but we put our soffit, so we made poplar soffit, so it's solid. You can see there, solid wood soffit, boxed it out, got our barge rafters out here. So that's where the metal roof is going to terminate, of course, and we'll have the trim that wraps around the corner here, or that wraps around the edge. So we're going to paint the face of this, painting it a charcoal color to match the metal roof. And here, Kelly's way out ahead of me already. So get some paint slapped on and then we'll put some drip edge and start hanging some metal. All right, so we got the parts painted we need in order to put the roof on. Now on this side, the downhill side, we actually have our 1x3 trim in place. So it's actually ready for siding. So we went ahead and painted that trim. We're gonna do the trim in the dark gray. So you can see this is obviously the trim elements underneath the soffit, the vertical down. We're gonna do that in the dark gray, the pop door. Of course, this is where they'll come out. So we could start putting siding on this, but obviously that's not what we're working on today. We're going to get the roof taken care of. We wanted to get it painted and dry, let it dry while we prepare to get our roof on. Our roof is metal roof is sitting over there and all of our trim pieces. So on to the next step. All right, so fast forward a couple hours. We actually had a little bit of a rainstorm come through, but fortunately, everything's dry to the touch. Oh, I can't move my hand. So let's get moving on the metal roofing. We're going to put some drip edge on both sides first, and then we're going to start putting on metal roof. .27 1/4, .51 1/4, and let's do .74. Get two of those longer blocks there and let's block that from your side. You got the Sharpie?
I do.
What's next?
74.
Oh, shoot, I should have got my drill ready. Sorry.
Do what?
I should have gotten my tool ready. I'm not ready to do this.
Going over the hill. Now, how high?
All right, so what we want is...
You want to come up and show me?
Yeah. We want just a little bit of a lip over the edge. And then we want to be flush over the side.
So this is what, a little bit more? Or?
Well, like, I like about that much. We just,
Sure
you got it held?
Yep. Where you? Oh. Are you sure we need to be up at the top? I'm not where I need to be.
You're moving like crazy.
I know.
Moving like a drunk. stretch. You can stretch the middle by pushing down on the rib and then getting a screw started, or putting a screw in an angle. So.
Oh yeah.
Fat man on a tiny house.
Just a baby. I did a baby. I did a baby. Honey. Yes, you are. You're so dirty. You're so dirty.
All right, last piece. Hand it up here. Are you going to hand me the drill? What are you handing me first? May have to have Cam bring it to me on the ladder.
What?
May have to have Cam bring it to me on the ladder.
No, because if I look
over
this, it's
going to
fall.
I'm not that bendy. All right, trying to stick the last piece here without sticking the landing. See how it goes. It's been a while since I've spread anything this wide. All right. Wrench it up here. Get my big foot out of the way. Don't worry about that. Does it look good?
That would be the only thing I would worry.
I don't care about falling. Does it look good?
Yeah. I look.
Look like we knew what we was doing. Now, how do I do this and still hold the camera? Camo, catch the camera. Come around here in front of you.
Pushing this corner up.
Is it, does it have more of an overhang than it should?
Well, now
it is.
Let me get back to where it was. There's that.
Holy crap, I knew what I was doing. Fuck. Don't show that part. I haven't cut it yet. Show this part. This is the better part. That actually fit. Ooh, that's sexy. Got to trim out this, cut out the bottom here. All right, so both the battery and the daylight are fading, and we've got obviously all the roof on, all the one piece of trim, gable trim, and we haven't done the front gable trim piece yet because we're just running out of daylight. But I need your all's help. Comment below, give me a link to a video, or describe exactly how to do these corners. So if you can see here, the videos I've watched, the gable trim doesn't have this raised area on this side, on the fascia side of all the videos I've seen. It has this buildup, and then it just comes here and comes flat. So these guys. All right, so the GoPro battery died, so we'll switch over to the iPhone here. So again, what I've seen is this side would just be flat and not have this extra bend in it. So when you bent this tab over, everything would flush up nicely. So I'm not quite sure how you're supposed to finish these bottom edges on this gable trim that has these multi-bends in it. So you see how it has this extra angle here. So I'd be curious. I'll keep looking on YouTube, but if you guys know, post a video below. Now, probably by the time I get this video out, I'll be done, but it'll be something I'll know for the future. So, all right. So next time you see us, we'll be... a little smudge on my face. We'll be on the other side, hopefully finishing that out. And then, of course, we've got to put the steeple on and the ridge cap. So the ridge cap will be the last thing we do. We're going to put the steeple on first and then ridge cap up to either side of the steeple. All right, so it's been a couple weeks because we've had a lot of projects going on. But coming back to, as far as you guys know, I haven't come back because it's just been a jump at it. But anyway, got the front trim piece on. And the research that I did, I think maybe I got corner trim instead of gable trim. Everything I've seen online for gable doesn't have this extra bend in it. So is what it is. Go with what you got. I discovered that after I cut all the pieces up, so what are you gonna do? So it doesn't look too bad. Doesn't look too good, but doesn't look too bad. So we've got that in place. The last piece is the ridge cap, but we need to put the steeple on because I don't want to, you know, normally if you're building a church or building a building that has a steeple, where'd my wife go? normally if you build a building that has a steeple, you build the steeple because it's part of the structure, and bell tower, all that type of stuff, and of course then you roof around it. Well, I don't want to do that just in case the steeple would fail or start to rot out or windstorm knock it off or something and have a leak. So the roof will be completely contained underneath, and the steeple will just set on top cosmetically. I didn't want to do a whole separate video on building the steeple, but flashback with me here real quick, and you'll just see some of the basics that I did to whip up together a steeple. And thanks to my dad for making the actual spire or pinnacle or whatever you'd call that, the very tip part of it. He made that for me on his metal break. So those pieces came together with these other things. Well, since I'd never built a steeple before, the idea was to start with a box that fit the shape of the roof, of course, the peak. So just using some poplar that I had milled, I've been laying around, I cut my angles to match the angle of the roof and built the initial base. Now, I was going to have to come back and cut the notches out for the ribs of the metal, but I wanted to get the box established first to make sure that this plan was actually going to work. It took a couple trips up to the chicken church to actually dry fit it to see how it was going to work and make my scribe marks to cut out those notches. But once I got that box established, then I knew, okay, now it's time for the tops. So I had some old plywood that actually had started to, the veneer had started to buckle. So I thought, well, let's use that and see what we can do. So just making a basic top for the first platform, something with a little bit of overhang, and then taking some leftover poplar, put a little chamfer edge on it to kind of give it that sexy detail. You know, you can't have a steeple without some sexy detail. Put that chamfered edge, and once I had that done, cut my 45s on the miter saw and glued and brad nailed them to the face. Now, it wasn't an issue since it was plywood. I don't have to worry about expansion and contraction if it was a solid piece of wood there. So once I had it figured out, just to go up a series of several boxes. So I made the next box about a third of the size and did the same with the cap, a piece of plywood, and then poplar edge trim with a chamfered finish on that edge. And lastly, of course, was the small box with the top to hold the spire, the peak, whatever, the steeple point, whatever you call that thing. That's what we put together. So once I had that laid out, it was just a matter of tying it all together and, of course, slapping some paint on it to make sure it matched the rest of the design. Hey, Kel, if you want to grab the base for me, pull out the base here. Mm-hmm. Oh, give me my level if you would please. That's right here inside the body.
This big one?
Yeah, the big red one. The big red one. So that block of ash is the part that's holding it to the roof. Everything else just sits on top. And that's something you're not going to hear very much anymore is a block of ash because it's all gone. All right, now time to put the pretty part on. So you hold these for now. Okay, so the front is the side opposite the rivets. That's the rivet side. So, I want to get it on the ladder like this. So right now, trading screws. So yeah, if you can carry it.
So you want that towards you when you come.
Exactly. Yeah, if you can carry it like that. Should the camera do this and you record?
Yeah. No.
Okay.
That won't be too heavy for the roof.
Get me, that's how I'm done. Laughing at?
I think it's pretty clever. I think you did a great job.
I'm laughing at my tongue actually.
But now that you said it, this kind of like a Chinese pagoda. That'd be a Japanese.
Hey, pagoda. You don't like being short, do you?
It's much better.
All right. Well, we're running out of daylight, but we got the steeple in place. I've got what I would call the roof completely done. All the trims on, ridge caps on. Steeples on, all that type of stuff. So, kind of looks like a country church, kind of looks like a Chinese dojo. I'm not quite sure. I'm not sure what we ended up with there, but oh well. Well, next we'll be moving on to putting the siding on and still got to build the doors. I've got two small pieces of stained glass we'll incorporate into the door as well to make it really nice. And then, I think I've got all of our lap siding milled and it's been drying. So as long as it hadn't curled up like bacon, we'll see how that goes. And obviously we'll continue on this project. Thank you all for coming along. See ya.